to solidify those spots even more. Only five events, three more to go in the online portion, but we're going to get right into the match. It's going to be Dr. Fate against Starfire as the base kicks in on that meter burn. Glyph Tweety pushing Biohazard to full screen.
There's a lot of discussion about this matchup. You know, these are two zoners going at it, but, you know, which one is, you know, has a better presence at full screen? Which one can really implement their gameplay?
All right. Positioning with the orb, Sweetie trying to keep Biohazard in the same spot, activates the character power, gets that dark magic, enhanced damage on all of his projectiles, and the properties change.
Trying to get something going here, but, you know, Tweety's just being so resilient to just mindlessly going in. He's being very patient and just letting Biohazard hang himself right now, or never mind, we had the name flipped around. Biohazard going with Dr. Fate in this situation.
Oh, well, just like he got bodied, we got bodied on the name switch, running it back. It seems he is the one in control. And again, the failed air dash, that back to such an amazing vertical hitbox. From the top of the sky to the bottom of the ground, projectiles galore. Who needs a combo when you can get the job done with the specials? A little antsy caught on the anti-air, keeping it safe. And again, just trading punches, trying to play the respectable game as we get into the clash here. Starfire, last ditch effort here, is going to spend two bars and regain 25%.
Dr. Fate right back to just plan A, just keep zoning, keep taking these trades because you have such a life lead that it's okay, you can do it. And, you know, Biohazard really needs to get something going here. Hits him with the overhead, trying to apply some more pressure, but gets hit by that wake up attack.
And luckily for Tweety, doesn't take any more, Biohazard doesn't take any more damage as we just try to figure it out piece by piece as we go along. Meter burn orb on the screen to halt all forward progress. And we're unlocking trophies. Bonus points, I don't know if they count towards IPS, but it looks good on paper. Meter burn orbs to the face, and Tweety, gonna guess, is gonna strike first blood as we get mixed up harder than the men actually playing the game here.
Biohazard going to character select screen. We've known Biohazard for a long time. We know that he's one of those players, you know, talented enough to feel comfortable in so many different skins and so many different characters. And, you know, I almost feel like he never doesn't feel at home in his portfolio of characters.
Oh, looking a little lost as we hover around the character select screen, trying to figure it out. Going back to Starfire again, Justice 2, a game where in the second year the meta is definitely shown to everyone at the top level having, you know, that sick roster of characters to complement the bad matchups. You will have to dig in that bag and go there, as you know you so far. But now jump three, a little more offensive for the start this time for Tweety with Dr. Fate, looking to protect those guys. And oh, running right into the 1-1. Plus frames on the meter burn glyph. Again, the properties changing while the character power is active. And Biohazard having an extremely hard time working his way in.
Tweety's was just so good at the start of both of these matches, really just kind of forcing Biohazard to make his way in. When you're running away with a lead, you're okay, you're fine with this. At this moment, Tweety wants to trade as much as possible, and Biohazard wants to be the aggressor, and that's when, you know, Tweety needs to kind of figure out when he's going to be striking and how to counter it perfectly.
All right, there's a character power denying the meter burn usage, but again, all trades working in Dr. Fate's favor right now. Great backdash to avoid that anti-air attempt.
Oh, man,
so rough. Finally getting his way in, running out of real estate as Tweety's back is to the wall. And it wouldn't be Injustice without handy interactables on deck, right?
Yeah, why not? Just throw them.
All right, more patience from both of these men. Not quite looking to lunge in with that 4-2. Tweety consistently in a crouching position, looking to react. But that time got caught pressing the button. Cross up now. First full combo. Not quite. Two bars on the air escape and an interruption.
And the challenge there. And, you know, that really, that's Tweety showing you how much he knows about not only his own character that he's playing right here, but the character that Biohazard is currently playing. He knows all about Starfire. He knows where all our holes and gaps are.
And the down two on the challenge, looking for the high attack on the follow-up. Biohazard in trouble once again, forced to use his clash before Tweety's even on his second life bar. But again, full meter, able to take advantage. Two bars back, a healthy 25%. And still has some meter to get the job done here. Yikes. All right, getting the Onks out, forcing him to maneuver by dashing over that orb. And Tweety just in control.
And this is a bad look here for Biohazard. He's got a huge mountain to climb here. And Tweety's life lead is just going right into these orbs. Meter burning it to keep it in place. Air escaping as a last resort here. And
so
Biohazard
good.
is down 2-0. Tweety taking this a lot more convincingly than it was in a combo breaker in top 8. That one was a slugfest back and forth. It came down to a Starfire mirror, if I remember correctly. And
Black Manta. All right, Biohazard digging in that bag. Won't quite see the Bane just yet, but it will be the blackest of Mantas looking to stab his way into more games in this set. Tweety, quick 2-0. Very dominant, very decisive. And wow, looking more offensive there for the sweep. Big anticipation, early reads, and a denial of the float. And yeah, Tweety firing on all cylinders now.
Look at all that chip damage here. And Tweety reading him like a book here, anti-airing him out of the sky and just putting those orbs right in front of him. He's just trying to find his way in. You've got to be feeling frustrated if you're a Biohazard right now.
And that is about as a hood perfect as it gets. This is looking kind of no entry at the door, if you know what I'm talking about. As Biohazard tries to figure it out, gets his first set of offense there, but again, sweet. Tweety, such immaculate spacing here in this matchup. Back two challenges, the glyph to keep it safe. No whiff punish there. It's been all Tweety so far.
Oh, just not close enough to get under those projectiles here as Tweety takes advantage, throwing him here.
Yeah, and this is just too much, too good. Throws the wheelchair, but I think the only handicapped person in this matchup is Biohazard. His offense can't really get going so far. I love the idea to try to escape, but double whiff punish, very easy to figure it out, and it's gonna need a little bit more than a miracle and become a real master on the spot, because this is looking all but over as Fate fills the screen with orbs once again.
And Tweety's just doing a great job of just blocking everything, and oh my god, the whiff punish here! Just smacking him right in his dome, back and forth, and, you know, Biohazard, again, here we go. The whiff punish, can it get started here? Dragging him all the way to the corner.
Right, looking for the bounce cancel to keep it plus, and the challenge on the float once again from Tweety back to full screen. And Black Manta's running out of time now. Full dash, no attempt on the whiff punish, but right back at you, and Tweety is going to secure a spot and winner.